हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज गिरिजेश कुमार मल, लेक्चरर इन इंग्लिश इन श्री गांधी विद्यालय इंटर कॉलेज बसरा रायबरेली। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, कैन यू थिंक ऑफ एनी साइंटिस्ट हु हैव आल्सो बीन स्टेटमेंट? यस, ही इज डॉक्टर अब्दुल कलाम, हु वाज एन इंडियन साइंटिस्ट एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर हु सर्व्ड एज द 11th प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया फ्रॉम 2002 टू 2007। He was born and raised in Rameswaram, Tamil Nadu, and is popularly known as the Missile Man of India for his work. Today, we are going to study about his childhood. The present chapter, My Childhood, is an extract from his biography, Wings of Fire. Kalam talks about his upbringing, his parents, and siblings in this chapter. He tells us about his friends and all those things that influenced his childhood. So, dear students, if you are ready, let us start the chapter. I was born into a middle-class Tamil family in the island town of Rameswaram in the erstwhile Madras state. Erstwhile, it means farmer. Actually, Kalam was born into a middle class Tamil family and his place of birth, Rameswaram, is an island town in the state of Tamil Nadu, in the Bay of Bengal. You can see it in the map. It is the place where Kalam was born. Today we know this state as Tamil Nadu, but when he was born, at that time the state was known as Madras state. He further says, my father Jainulabdin had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom and a true generosity of his spirit. Innate, it means inborn. Actually, Kalam's father's name was Jainulabdin. Kalam says that his father was not very rich. He did not have much wealth. He was not highly educated. But despite these disadvantages, he had some other qualities. He was naturally very wise and was generous too. He had an ideal helpmate in my mother, Ashiyamma. Helpmate, it means support. Actually, Kalam's mother's name was Ashiyamma, who was kind lady, generous lady, and she used to help his father. She was a great support and help to him. He further says, I do not recall the exact number of people she fed every day, but I am quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together. Actually, Kalam's mother was very generous and kind-hearted lady. Every day she used to feed a lot of people. She fed a greater number of people from outside than the total number of the members in their family. Now come to the next paragraph. I was one of many children, a short boy with rather undistinguished looks, born to tall and handsome parents. Handsome parents. Actually, Kalam had many siblings and he describes himself that he had short height and common looks. He did not have any exceptional looks. On the contrary, his parents were very tall and handsome. they were good looking. Kalam did not inherit their physical qualities. Dear students, can you tell me what does Kalam say about his parents? Actually, he tells us about the personality of his parents. Okay? Come to the next line. We lived in our ancestral house. Ancestral, Patrick, which was built in the middle of the 19th century. It was a fairly large pakka house made of limestone and brick on the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram. Actually, Kalam's ancestral house was very old. It was built in the 19th century. It was a pakka house which was made of bricks and limestone. And it is located on the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram. He further says, my austere father, austere, it means simple but strict father, used to avoid all inessential comforts and luxuries. However, all necessities were provided for in terms of food, medicine or clothes. Actually, Kalam's father was very simple, but he was strict also. He wanted to live his life in a simple way, and he used to teach his children not to waste money on unnecessary things. Kalam says that his father used to avoid any kind of inessential comfort and luxuries. He provided them all the necessary things like food, clothes and medicines. Dear students, which type of person Kalam's father was? Can you tell me? Actually, Kalam's father was very simple but strict person. Okay? Let us come to the next paragraph. In fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood, both materially and emotionally. Materially, it means economically. Emotionally, it means in terms of love and affection. Kalam says that his parents fulfilled all his needs, whether it is related to economy or their love and affection. These shows that he has the quality of gratitude. Dear students, these qualities shows that he has the quality of gratitude. Kalam is thankful to his parents for whatever they did for him. Now come to the next paragraph. The Second World War broke out in 1939. When I was 8 years old, for a reason I have never been able to understand, a sudden demand for tamarind seeds erupted in the market. I used to collect the seeds and sell them to the provision shop on Mosque Street. A day's collection would fetch me the princely sum of one anna. Here there is a word, tamarind seeds. Tamarind is one kind of fruit, just like this. You can see it in the picture. Actually, Kalam was 8 years old when the Second World War broke in the year 1939. So, we can calculate that he was born in the year 1931. The demand for tamarind seeds increased in the market. Kalam used to collect and sell the tamarind seeds to the provision shop located on Mask Street. He would earn a mere sum of 1 anna, which equals 6 paise. When he addresses it as a princely sum, something very great and valuable, he is being ironic, as the amount was very much. At that time, this 1 anna meant a lot of money to him. Clear? Come to the next paragraph. My brother-in-law, Jalaluddin, would tell me stories about the war, which I would later attempt to trace in the headlines in Deenamani. Dear students, Deenamani was a Tamil daily newspaper. Actually, Kalam's brother-in-law, Jalaluddin, used to tell him the stories of ongoing world war. And later, Kalam used to read the newspaper Deenamani and used to look for the news of the same stories. He further says, our area being isolated was completely unaffected by the war. But soon, India was forced to join the Allied forces and something like a state of emergency was declared. Here, isolated. Isolated means cut off. And Allied forces. Allied forces, the armies of United Kingdom, United States of America, and Russia during the Second World War. Actually, Rameswaram was a small island town far away from land. So, it was not affected by the World War in the beginning. But after some time, India had to join the World War and combined with the Allied forces, with the armies of United Kingdom, with the armies of United States of America, with the armies of Russia. Then a state of emergency was declared in the country. Actually, during emergency, the president's rules are implemented in the country. It is like a curfew in the country, a lot of privileges which are given to the people are withdrawn. Clear? Then what happened? The first casualty came in the form of the suspension of the train halt at Rameswaram station. Casualty, it means loss. Halt, it means stop. Actually, the first impact of World War II on the people of Rameswaram was the cancellation of train stoppage at the Rameswaram station. Clear? Earlier, the train which came from India used to stop Rameswaram station and then went further to Dhanushkodi. But now the halt was cancelled and the train went from India to Dhanushkodi directly without stopping at the Rameswaram. Clear? It was the first casualty. Now come to the next paragraph. The newspapers now had to be bundled and thrown out from the moving train on the Rameswaram road between Rameswaram and Dhanushkodi. Actually, due to cancellation of halt, the newspaper bundle which used to come for Rameshwaram was thrown out of the moving train as it reached Rameshwaram Road. That forced my cousin Shamsuddin, who distributed newspapers in Rameshwaram, to look for the helping hand to catch the bundles, and as if naturally, I filled the slot. Filled the slot, it means fit into the place easily. Shamsuddin helped me earn my first wages. Actually, Kalam's cousin, Shamsuddin, used to distribute the newspapers in Rameshwaram. As the train stoppage was cancelled and the newspaper bundle was thrown out of the moving train, he needed someone to help him catch the bundle. So, Kalam helped Shamsuddin by catching the bundle and distributing the newspaper. And in return, Shamsuddin paid him a salary, which was Kalam's first earning. Dear students, can you tell me who needed the help of someone? There is a question. Who needed the help of someone? Yes, Kalam's cousin Shamsuddin needed the help of someone to catch the bundle. Very good. Come to the next line. Half a century later, I can still feel the surge of pride in earning my own money for the first time. Feel the surge of pride, sudden feeling of satisfaction. Sudden feeling. And half a century later, it means after a period of 50 years. Actually, this incident happened 50 years ago. Even now, when he wrote this book, he wrote his biography, he could feel satisfied and proud of himself. Kalam says that whenever someone earns his own money with his own hard work, he feels it the same way as he did at that time. Clear? Come to the next paragraph. Every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific socio-economic and emotional environment, and trained in certain ways by figures of authority. I inherited honesty and self-discipline from my father. From my mother, I inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness, and so did my three brothers and sisters. Actually, figures of authority. It means a person who has authority over another person. A person who has the power to give orders or make decision. And socio-economic, it means in terms of money. Actually, Kalam says that for a child, the figure of authority is his parents, and the next figure of authority can be his teacher, a person who has authority over the child. Kalam is saying that whenever a child is born, he has some quality which he acquires from the elders in his family. These depended upon the social status of the family and the environment at home. From his father, he inherited honesty and self-discipline. And from his mother, he inherited faith in goodness and deep kindness. And his siblings also inherited these qualities from their parents. Here, dear students, you can see the picture of his family. Here, there are members in his family, his father, his mother, and brother and sister. Now, come to the next paragraph. I had three close friends in my childhood. Ramananda Shastri, Aravindan, and Suprakasan. All these boys were from orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. Orthodox, it means very strict. Kalam had three best friends during his childhood. And their names are Ramananda Shastri, Aravindan, and Suprakasan. All of them belong to a very strict Hindu Brahmin families and were ardent followers of their religion. Dear students, can you tell me the name of Kalam's friend? Yes, their names are Ramananda Shastri, Aravindan, and Suprakasan. Very good. Come to the next paragraph. As children, none of us ever felt any difference among us ourselves because of our religious differences and upbringing. In fact, Ramananda Shastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshman Shastri, the high priest of the Rameshwaram temple. Actually, Kalam was from a Muslim family. He says that during his childhood, all the children were so close to each other that they never felt they belonged to different religions. And religion was not a barrier in their friendship. There is a very famous temple in Rameshwaram, the Rameshwaram temple. And Kalam's best friend, Ramananda Shastri, was the son of Pakshi Lakshman Shastri, the priest of that temple. Then what happened? Come to the next paragraph. Later, he took over the priesthood of the Rameshwaram temple from his father. Aravindan went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims, and Suprakasan became a catering contractor for the Southern Railways. Actually, when these three friends grew up, Ramananda Shastri took the priesthood of the Rameshwaram temple. Aravindan started a business of transporting the pilgrims, and Suprakasan became a catering contractor for the Southern Railway. He was in charge of the catering for the railways. Dear students, I think it is enough for today. We have studied today about the parented, upbringing, siblings, and his friends. It was the major and important part of Kalam's childhood. As you have been told that Kalam's friends were Brahmin. Even then, there was a great understanding and bondage within them. Kalam was very diligent from his childhood, as you have come to know that he served as the newspaper hawker. Dear students, now it is the turn of important questions and answers. There may be some important questions from this portion, like, where was Abdul Kalam's house? The answer is, Abdul Kalam's house was located on the Mosque Street in the town of Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu state. Now come to the next question. What do you think Dinamani is the name of? Give a reason for your answer. Here is the answer of this very question. Dinamani is the name of a newspaper. It is a vernacular daily printed in Tamil language. I think so because Kalam says that he traced the stories of the Second World War in the headlines of the Dinamani. Come to the next question. Who were Abdul Kalam's school friends? What did they later become? During his childhood, Abdul Kalam had three friends. Their names are Ramananda Shastri, Arbindan, Suprakasham. When they grew up, Ramananda Shastri became the priest of the Rameshwaram temple. Arbindan started a business of transporting pilgrims from the Rameshwaram temple, and Suprakasham became a caterer for the railways. Clear? Now, next question is, how did Abdul Kalam earn his first wages? And the answer of this very question is, Abdul Kalam earned his first wages by catching the bundle of newspapers thrown out of the moving train at the Rameshwaram station. He helped his cousin in distributing newspapers in Rameshwaram. Dear students, now please note down the homework. And there is a question in as a homework. Answer this question in short paragraph. How does the author, Kalam, describe his father, his mother, himself? You have to write a short paragraph about Kalam's father, about Kalam's mother, and about himself. So, dear students, now we shall discuss the rest part of the lesson in the next lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day.